child there. We gotta get dinner cooked. We gotta take care of maybe a parent, maybe a niece, maybe a nephew, maybe a grandchild. But in all of that equation, where are you? Where do you find yourself? All I'm saying is we just have to take a little bit of time to make the new you the best you. It's time to sharpen our own saw, as Franklin Covey and Stephen Covey would say. It's time to take care of ourselves, accomplish our goals, meet our dreams. That way we can take care of ourselves, get our health better in check, because I know many of you, like myself, are health on the back burner. Our health, one of the last things we take care of. And then what happens? When we're down, what happens? I mean, let's just be real with it. When we're down, somebody's got to take care of the children. Somebody's got to take care of the husband. Somebody's still got to go to work. We probably go to work sick, coughing and hacking all over each other. But we really don't have that downtime, that time to take care of ourselves. So what I'm saying, sisters, is it's time to make the new you the best you. Now, I want us to think about why. I'll tell you what, for me, and I can only speak for me in this particular case, why am I doing this? Because I can no longer, in good conscience, just sit here and know, with all the knowledge that I have, the personal experiences that I have, I cannot sit in good conscience and watch people that I know, people that I love, people that I witness suffer. I can't, in good conscience, just sit there and watch our youth, who are making some of the decisions that we made some bad ones. I will admit, I made some bad ones myself. But if you look at the youth today, they're making decisions that just don't make sense, and they just don't understand the impact of them. I'm talking about the 16-year-old girl, the one who's getting pregnant, think it's cute, having these pregnant clubs with all these girls getting pregnant at the same time. I'm talking about that teenage girl who's about to go into college, maybe into high school, and is thinking about what's going on in their life and what are some of the next steps they've got to make. But sometimes the finances aren't there. Sometimes the outside environment doesn't allow them to do the things that they do. So what happens? Sometimes they make the wrong decisions. Sometimes they get into the wrong relationships. And at the end of the day, who suffers? They might even run a child into the world, as an example, and a result of some of those decision making. I'm talking to that college student who's in college, got things going, looking at the straight and narrow, see light at the end of the tunnel. And they may make a wrong decision and they're somewhere. And then what happens? They're off the right, off the wrong path and onto the wrong path. I'm talking about that young woman who maybe just got out of college, who's trying to figure out, what do I do in my life? What's next? Do I get a job? Do I start my own job? I'm scared. I don't want to start my own job. I'm scared of success. I'm fearful that I might not succeed. I'm fearful that someone might not like me. But then, so I'm talking to you. I'm talking about putting down all the excuses. And if you're one of those individuals who says, oh, I ain't got time for this. Oh, I'll do it Monday. Oh, I don't know about that. Then I need to just turn off this video because I don't have time for it. And I'm being sincere. I want to talk to that sister, that individual who says, you know what? She isn't talking just about me. She is saying something that resonates with me. And I need to do something about it. She's right. Let me think about it a little more. Yeah, she's right. I've denied it for years. I've turned it away for years. But you know what? You know that what I'm telling you right now resonates with you. So, if you're that individual who's going to get up, who's going to do something, who's going to do something and help someone else, then I want you to keep listening to this video. But if you're not, turn it off. And I don't mean to be rude, but you know who you are. You know you're the individual that says and wants to talk about all the things that are wrong, but don't want to do anything about it. So I'm talking to you. If that's you, turn it off. Don't waste your time.